Isabel, you are the curator of this exhibition at the Morgan Library, about a fantastic library, in fact, of science. Could you tell us a story?
Yes, it's an old story because it began in 1993, so quite a long time ago. I was then a curator in the French National Library in Paris, in the rare books department. And I was already, I was quite young and already fascinated with bindings. And I knew the Bibliothèque Nationale would leave the Rue de Richelieu to the new building in Tolbiac, and I did not want to go there. So I knew I would leave, and I decided, I had 5 years left before the departure, to look at all the bindings in my fabulous collection, which is one of the best in the world, of course, the Bibliothèque Nationale collection. So it was quite a Stakhanovist work. I began by one point of the stores, and I took one after one all the nearly 200,000 books in hand. It took me 5 years. Yes, I left in 1998. And noting what was interesting in terms of bindings, because that was my main focus. And I was happy because quite shortly after I became this very, very long trip, I bumped into two fantastic Renaissance bindings, both of them on architecture books. They were Vitruve, two editions of Vitruve. And they were, I should show you pictures, of course, but they were very, very interesting in terms of decoration, gilt, and so on Morocco. And when I opened them, I noticed on the what we call the fly leaf, that is the first blank leaf of the book, a big number written in an old ink, N16 century. And both books had no origin, no verified origin. There was no ex libris, no coat of arms, nothing to tell where they were coming from and whom they belonged to. But they had the same kind of number, not the same number, of course, but the same kind. So I noted it and I went on. And in a few months, I had discovered more than 30 fantastic books of this type on the shelves of my department, reserve department, all on not only on architecture, or very different kind of books, Latin literature, medicine, everything, Greek literature a little, and always absolutely anonymous. I knew quite well the what we call the shelf marks and all the marks that we use to trace the history of a book in such a national library, and I had never seen that. So it was
only books from the 16th century?
They were all incunabula or 16th century. There were a few manuscripts also. And so I had already guessed they belonged to the same collector who had ordered the bindings, but I could not find who it was. It was very well hidden. And the most recent book I could find, it was in another, I went on in other libraries, the Mazarine where I worked later, Saint-Geneviève and so on and so on. And the most recent book, if I can say, was dated 1569. So I began fascinated with all the people who died in 1570, because I suppose it was the only explanation for that. And I studied at the École des Chartes, so I came back to the archives, I looked at inventories after death, reading all those I could to see if they described my books, but it was unsuccessful. And finally, maybe 3 or 4 years later, I don't remember exactly now, I spoke about that to a friend of mine, Pascal Racmadou, who is a bookseller and a very expert, one of the best experts in bindings in the world, I would say. And he was asked by my colleagues, curators of the manuscripts department, to help them in preparing an exhibition about bindings. So he was on the shelves with them. And he opened a manuscript of poetry that was considered so to be the copy of King Charles IX, poetry by a French young follower of Ronsard, who is called Philippe Desportes. And when opening this magnificent book with a magnificent binding, but quite different from ours, with a double C inscribed on the cover, he found what we call the code brune, so this number, inventory number, in the same kind of letter. And the poem was a series of love poems written in the year 1570, where Philippe Desportes, the young poet, was saying, "Oh, I must hate you, awful year 1570. I just had one friend, perfect and wise, and death took him in his jaws. And another awful thing in that year, I've lost my mistress, whom I loved so much." And with that, I could understand that Philippe Desportes was mourning a young man called Claude de Laubépine, who was absolutely unknown to me, I must confess, until that moment. And
what year was it?
Sorry?
What year was it?
1570.
No, that you guessed.
1998, something like that, because it was the preparation of the exhibition Royal Bindings. I don't remember. Enfin, I could thread that, of course.
Okay.
And the lady he was in love with was Claude's sister, Madeleine de Laubépine, who married Nicolas de Villeroy, whose grandchildren should turn the Duke of Villeroy. So everything fitted. I had found somebody who died in 1570. And everything like a puzzle that was taking its shape. So I went on searching because I found others in British libraries. I gave a talk at the British Library. I found some in America. I found some very important in a few private collections, very few. Most of them are in public institutions. And then I began to write and write about that. And this Claude de Laubépine, whose name I had never seen before, as I already told, he died 25 years old, so very young, if in those times people were adults earlier than nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
And he was the son of the what is called at that time Secretary of State, that is something like a minister. Who was something like the prime minister of Queen Catherine de' Medici when she was the regent of France.